Rádio Batuta apresenta A Voz Humana, com Elcanaã Ferraz.
O programa de hoje, à primeira vista, ou melhor, à primeira audição, não traz nenhuma música. Ouviremos uma seleção de poemas lidos pelos próprios poetas. Portanto, há uma musicalidade que deve ser ouvida no encadeamento das palavras, nas pausas, inflexões. Mas estaremos, sobretudo, diante da voz, de sua presença absoluta. Quando ouvimos um poeta lendo seus versos, deparamos com o que parece ser uma síntese das dimensões física e emotiva do autor. Começaremos com a norte-americana Gertrude Stein. Vamos ouvir If I Told Him, A Completed Portrait of Picasso. Repare nas repetições das palavras e sons, um artifício característico da poesia de Gertrude Stein, que dá a seu texto um caráter rítmico, ressaltado pela leitura.
If I told him, would he like it? Would he like it if I told him? Would he like it? Would Napoleon? Would Napoleon? Would he like it? If Napoleon, if I told him, if I told him, if Napoleon, would he like it if I told him, if I told him, if Napoleon? Would he like it if Napoleon, if I told him? If I told him, if Napoleon, if Napoleon, if I told him? If I told him, would he like it? Would he like it if I told him? Now, not now, and now. Now, exactly as kings, feeling full for it, exactitude as kings, so to beseech you as full as for it, exactly or as kings. Shutters shut and open, so do queens. Shutters shut and shutters, and so shutters shut and shutters, and so shutters, and so shutters shut, and so shutters shut, and shutters, and so shutters shut, and so, and also, and also, and so, and so, and also. Exact resemblance to exact resemblance, the exact resemblance, exact as a resemblance. Exactly as resembling, exactly in resemblance, exactly a resemblance, exactly and resemblance. For this is so, because. Now actively repeat it all, now actively repeat it all, now actively repeat it all. Have, hold, and hear actively repeat it all. I judge, as a resemblance to him. Who comes first? Napoleon the first. Who comes to, coming to? Who goes there? As they go, they share. Who shares all? All is as all, as yet or as yet. Now to date, now and date and the date. Who came first? Napoleon at first. Who came first? Napoleon the first. Who came first? Napoleon first. Presently. Exactly do they do. First exactly. Exactly do they do too. First exactly and first exactly. Exactly do they do, and first exactly and exactly, and do they do, at first exactly, and do they do, the first exactly, and do they do, the first exactly, at first exactly, first as exactly, at first as exactly, presently, as presently. He, he, and he, and he, and as he, and as he, and he. He is, and as he is, and as he is, and he is. He is, and as he, and he, and as he is, and he, and he, and he. Can curls rob, can curls quote quotable, as presently, as exactitude, as trains, has trains, has trains, as trains, as trains presently, proportions presently, as proportions as presently. Father and father, was the king or room, father and weather. Was there, what was there, what was there, was there, whether and in there, as even say so, one I land, two I land, three the land, three the land, three the land, two I land, one I land, two I land, as a so, they cannot, a note, they cannot, afloat, they cannot, they don't, they cannot, they as denote, miracles play fairly well, a well, as or as presently. Let me recite what history teaches. History teaches.
Considerado um dos mais importantes e inovadores poetas do século XX, o norte-americano E. Cummings lê aqui As Freedom is a Breakfast Food. O poema apresenta um quadro da América durante a Grande Depressão, entre 1929 e a Segunda Guerra Mundial. Cummings lê acentuando a musicalidade dos versos, quase como se fosse guiado por uma partitura.
As freedom is a breakfast food, or truth can live with right and wrong, or molehills are from mountains made, long enough and just so long will being pay the rent of seam and genius please the talent gang and water most encourage flame. As hat racks into peach trees grow, or hopes dance best on bald men's hair, and every finger is a toe and every courage is a fear, long enough and just so long will the impure think all things pure, and hornets wail by children stung. Or as the seeing are the blind, and robins never welcome spring, nor flat folk prove their world is round, nor dinksters die at break of dawn, and commons rare, and millstones float, long enough and just so long, tomorrow will not be too late. Worms are the words, but joy's the voice. Down shall go which, and up come who. Breasts will be breasts, thighs will be thighs. Deeds cannot dream what dreams can do. Time is a tree, this life one leaf, but love is the sky and I am for you, just so long and long enough.
Prosseguimos com o grande Jorge Luis Borges. O argentino, poeta e prosador, lê de maneira muito simples, o que torna mais estranha a situação de seu texto, que trata de um tema fundamental de sua obra. O duplo. É o que ouviremos em Borges e Joe.
Al otro, a Borges, es a quien le ocurren las cosas. Yo camino por Buenos Aires y me demoro, acaso ya mecánicamente, para mirar el arco de un zaguán y la puerta cancel. De Borges tengo noticias por el correo y veo su nombre en una terna de profesores o en un diccionario biográfico. Me gustan los relojes de arena, los mapas, las etimologías, la tipografía del siglo XVIII, el sabor del café y la prosa de Stevenson. El otro comparte esas preferencias, pero de un modo vanidoso, que las convierte en atributos de un actor. Sería exagerado afirmar que nuestra relación es hostil. Yo vivo, yo me dejo vivir, para que Borges pueda tramar su literatura. Y esa literatura me justifica. Nada me cuesta confesar que ha logrado ciertas páginas válidas. Pero esas páginas no me pueden salvar. Quizá porque lo bueno ya no es de nadie, ni siquiera del otro, sino del lenguaje o la tradición. Por lo demás, yo estoy destinado a perderme definitivamente. Y solo algún instante de mí podrá sobrevivir en el otro. Poco a poco voy cediéndole todo, aunque me consta su perversa costumbre de falsear y magnificar. Spinoza entendió que todas las cosas quieren perseverar en su ser. La piedra eternamente quiere ser piedra y el tigre un tigre. Yo he de quedar en Borges, no en mí, si es que alguien soy. Pero me reconozco menos en sus libros que en muchos otros, o que en el laborioso rasgueo de una guitarra. Hace años yo traté de librarme de él y pasé de las mitologías del arrabal a los juegos con el tiempo y con lo infinito. Pero esos juegos son de Borges ahora y tendré que idear otras cosas. Así mi vida es una fuga y todo lo pierdo y todo es del olvido o del otro. No sé cuál de los dos escribe esta página.
A primeira voz brasileira é de Murilo Mendes, que lê Metafísica da Moda. Sua leitura eloquente sublinha a dimensão erótica dos versos, que que reúne a simplicidade física da moda e a projeção surrealista do desejo frente à presença feminina.
Tudo que te rodeia e te serve aumenta a fascinação e o mistério. Teu véu se interpõe entre ti e o meu corpo, é a grade do meu cárcere. Tuas luvas macias ao tacto fazem crescer a nostalgia das mãos que não receberam meu anel no altar. Tua maquilhagem é uma desforra sobre a natureza. Tuas joias e teus perfumes são necessários a ti e à ordem do mundo como o pão ou faminto. Eu me enrolo nas tuas peles, nos teus boás, rasgo teu petilho de seda para beijar teus seios brancos que alimentam os poemas. Entreabro a túnica fosforescente para me abrigar no teu ventre glorioso que ampliou o mundo ao lhe dar um homem a mais. Teus vestidos obedecem a um plano inspirado. Correspondem-se com o céu, o mar, as estrelas, com teus pensamentos, teus desejos, tuas sensações. A natureza inteira é retalhada para ornar teu corpo. Os homens derrubam florestas, descem até o fundo das minas e dos mares, movem as máquinas, os teares, soltam os aviões nos ares, lutam pela posse da terra, matam e roubam pelo teu corpo. O mundo sai de ti, vem desembocar em ti e te contempla espantado e apaixonado. Arco-íris terrestre, fonte da nossa angústia e da nossa alegria. Tudo que faz parte de ti, desde teus sapatos, está unido ao prazer e ao pecado, à teologia, ao sobrenatural.
A norte-americana Elizabeth Bishop é uma exímia observadora do real. Seus poemas podem ser marcadamente descritivos, sobretudo quando trata de paisagens ou animais. A voz de Bishop parece frágil, mas algo nela é cortante. Sua leitura despe-se de qualquer efeito dramático e, em The Fish, acentua o caráter de crônica do poema, que narra sua visão de um peixe que acabara de pescar.
I caught a tremendous fish and held him beside the boat half out of water, with my hook fast in the corner of his mouth. He didn't fight. He hadn't fought at all. He hung a grunting weight, battered and venerable and homely. Here and there his brown skin hung in strips like ancient wallpaper, and its pattern of darker brown was like wallpaper, shapes like full-blown roses, stained and lost through age. He was speckled with barnacles, fine rosettes of lime, and infested with tiny white sea lice, and underneath two or three rags of green weed hung down. While his gills were breathing in the terrible oxygen, the frightening gills, fresh and crisp with blood that can cut so badly, I thought of the coarse white flesh packed in like feathers, the big bones and the little bones, the dramatic reds and blacks of his shiny entrails, and the pink swim bladder like a big peony. I looked into his eyes, which were far larger than mine, but shallower and yellowed, the irises backed and packed with tarnished tin foil, seen through lenses of old scratched isinglass. They shifted a little, but not to return my stare. It was more like the tipping of an object toward the light. I admired his sullen face, the mechanism of his jaw, and then I saw that from his lower lip, if you could call it a lip, grim, wet, and weapon-like, hung five old pieces of fish line, or four and a wire leader with the swivel still attached, with all their five big hooks grown firmly in his mouth. A green line frayed at the end where he broke it, two heavier lines, and a fine black thread still crimped from the strain and snap when it broke and he got away. Like medals with their ribbons frayed and wavering, a five-haired beard of wisdom trailing from his aching jaw. I stared and stared, and victory filled up the little rented boat from the pool of bilge where oil had spread a rainbow around the rusted engine to the baler rusted orange, the sun-cracked thwarts, the oarlocks on their strings, the gunnels, until everything was rainbow, rainbow, rainbow. And I let the fish go.
Dylan Thomas nasceu no país de Gales, parte do Reino Unido, e escreveu desde sempre em língua inglesa. Seu lirismo intenso e carregado de emoção torna-se evidente em sua leitura, na qual ouvimos claramente a dimensão melódica dos versos. É o que se poderá ouvir em Do Not Go Gentle Into That Good Night.
Old age should burn and rave at close of day. Rage, rage against the dying of the light. The wise men at their end know dark is right. Because their words had forked no lightning, they do not go gentle into that good night. Good men the last wave by, crying how bright their frail deeds might have danced in a green bay. Rage, rage against the dying of the light. Wild men who caught and sang the sun in flight, and learned too late they grieved it on its way, do not go gentle into that good night. Grave men near death, who see with blinding sight, blind eyes could blaze like meteors and be gay. Rage, rage against the dying of the light. And you, my father, there on the sad height, curse, bless me now with your fierce tears, I pray. Do not go gentle into that good night. Rage, rage against the dying of the light.
A língua portuguesa permanece, mas agora vem de Portugal, com o magnífico Mário Cesarini. Além do mistério que parece emergir dos versos do poema You Are Welcome to Elsinore, a própria leitura de Cesarini, sua respiração, suas pausas, suas modulações, tudo parece vir de um corpo tocado pelo mistério e pela revelação.
Entre nós e as palavras há metal fundente. Entre nós e as palavras há hélices que andam e podem dar-nos morte, violar-nos, tirar do mais fundo de nós o mais útil segredo. Entre nós e as palavras há perfis ardentes, espaços cheios de gente de costas, altas flores venenosas, portas por abrir, escadas e ponteiros, e crianças sentadas à espera do seu tempo e do seu precipício. Ao longo da muralha que habitamos, há palavras de vida, há palavras de morte, há palavras imensas que esperam por nós e outras frágeis que deixaram de esperar. Há palavras acesas como barcos e há palavras homens, palavras que guardam o seu segredo e a sua posição. Entre nós e as palavras, surdamente, as mãos e as paredes de Elsinor. E há palavras noturnas, palavras gemidos, palavras que nos sobem elegíveis à boca, palavras diamantes, palavras nunca escritas, palavras impossíveis de escrever, por não termos connosco cordas de violinos, nem todo o sangue do mundo, nem todo o amplexo do ar. E os braços dos amantes escrevem muito alto, muito além do asilo onde oxidados morrem. Palavras maternais, só sombra, só soluço, só espasmos, só amor, só solidão desfeita. Entre nós e as palavras, os emparedados. E entre nós e as palavras, o nosso dever falar.
Adonis é o mais importante poeta moderno do mundo árabe. Nascido na Síria, adotou os procedimentos modernos da poesia ocidental, como o verso livre e a ausência de rimas. Em sua leitura, no entanto, ouvimos o soar da música tradicional árabe. Vamos ouvir Os Dias do Falcão.
Fawqa wajhiya bayna al-farisati wal-farisi rimahu. جسدي يتدحرج والموت حوذيه والرياح جسس تتدلى ومرثية وكأن النهار حجر يثقب الحياة وكأن النهار عربات من الدمع غير رنينك يا صوت أسمع صوت الفرات قريش قافلة تبحر ثوب الهند تحمل نار المجد والسماء على الجرح ممدودة والضفاف تتهامس تمتد بيني وبين الضفاف لغة بيننا حوار حضنته الكراكي طافت به كالشراع بيننا وفراتا كن لي جسرا وكن لي قناع وترسبت غير رنينك يا صوت أسمع صوت الفرات قريش لؤلؤة تشع من دمشق يخبئها الصندل واللبان أرق ما رق له لبنان أجمل ما حدث عنه الشرق وأنا في فضاء الجنادب تحت الغيوم الجريحة حجر ميت الجناح حجر ميت القوادم والموت يسرج أفراسه والذبيحة بجع يتخبط غير رنينك يا صوت أسمع صوت الفرات قريش لم يبق من قريش غير الدم النافر مثل الرمح لم يبق غير الجرح افتحي افتحي يا براري مصاريع أبوابك الصدئات ملك والفضاء خراجي ومملكتي خطواتي ملك أتقدم أبني فتوحي فوق هذا الجليد المؤصل فوق الجموح أعرف أن أجرح الرمل أزرع في جرحه النخيل أعرف أن أبعث الفضاء القتيل والطريق يدحرج أهواله ويضيق والطريق مرايا كتب ومرايا أتقرأ تجاويفها أتفرس ألمس فيها بقايا فارس عاشق الخطى أقرأ الخطوة والعشب والنخيل وأفقا نسجته التنهدات القصيرة حيث لا يهدأ الحريق حيث لا تنتهي الخطوات الأميرة في الشقوق تفيأت كنت أجس الدقائق أمخض ثدي القفار سرت أمضى من السهم أمضى عقرت الحصى والغبار كانت الأرض أضيق من ظل رمحي مت سمعت العقارب كيف تصيء هديت القطاف المجاهل مت انحنيت على الأرض أكثر صبرا من الأرض مت انكببت على كاهل الريح صليت وشوشت حتى الحجار وقرأت النجوم كتبت عناوينها ومحوت راسما شهوتي خريطة ودمي حبرها وأعماقي البسيطة ساهر بين جذري وأغصانه والمياه نضبت والتوابع مملوءة الجباه زهرا يابسا وقبورا وديعة صاعد لبروج التحول حيث الفجيعة حيث يساقط الرماد حيث يستيقظ النشيج وينطفئ السندباد لو أنني أعرف كالشاعر أن أغير الفصول لو أنني أعرف أن أكلم الأشياء سحرت قبر الفارس الطفل على الفرات قبر أخي في شاطئ الفرات مات بلا غسل ولا قبر ولا صلاة. وقلت للأشياء والفصول تواصلي كهذه الأجواء، مدي لي الفرات، خليه ماء دافقا أخضر كالزيتون في دمي العاشق في تاريخي المسنون. لو أنني أعرف كالشاعر أن أشارك النبات أعراسه، قنعت هذا الشجر العارية بالأطفال. لو أنني أعرف كالشاعر أن أدجن الغرابة، سويت كل حجر سحابة تمطر فوق الشام والفرات. لو أنني أعرف كالشاعر أن أغير الآجال، لو أنني أعرف أن أكون نبوءة تنذر أو علامة، لصحت يا غمامة تكاثفي وأمطري باسمي فوق الشام والفرات. بالله يا غمامة. السماء انفتحت، صار التراب كتبا، والله في كل كتاب ساهر. لم يبق في وجهي صخر نائم، لم يبق في عيني سرى علامة تأتي من الفرات. أنا هو الساكن في طوقك يا حمامة، في سربك الراحل يا خطاف. أنا هو الواضع كالعراف، رؤياه والعلامة في الأفق في لغاته الكثيرة. أنا هو الفرات والجزيرة، علامة علامة مهلك يا حنيني. الصقر في بادية العروق في مدائن السريرة، الصقر كالهالة مرسوم على بوابة الجزيرة، والصقر تطريز على عباءة الصحراء، والصقر في الحنين في الحيرة بين الحلم والبكاء، والصقر في متاهه في يأسه الخلاق، يبني على الذروة في نهاية الأعماق. أندلس الأعماق، أندلس الطالع من دمشق، يحمل للغرب حصاد الشرق، يكتب الصقر للفضاء لمجهوله السخي، سائلا عن مكان كشريانه نقي. يومئ الصقر للصقور متعب، حملته متاهاته، حملته الصخور فحنى فوقها يغذي متاهاته، ويغذي الصخور وجهه يتقدم، والشمس حوذيه والفضاء موقد، والرياح عجوز تقص حكاياتها، والصقور موكب يفتح السماء. يرفع كالعاشق في تفجر مريد في وله الصبوة والإشراق، أندلس الأعماق يرفعها للكون هذا الهيكل الجديد. كل فضاء باسمه كتاب، وكل ريح باسمه نشيد.
A Voz Humana. Roteiro e apresentação: Eucanaã Ferraz. Edição: Felipe de Castro. Rádio Batuta, a rádio de internet do Instituto Moreira Salles.